name is Kanika Kulandai-Villu, and I am a final year PhD candidate at Virginia Tech's Department of Geosciences, and I'm all set to finish in a couple of months. I'm pursuing a PhD in geophysics. For my PhD, we went to the field and we collected a set of conductive heat flow data in the Panama Basin, which is a ridge flank. I've been looking at how hydrothermal circulation impacts the ocean floor. So I've gotten comfortable with the processes around mid-ocean ridges. And when I saw the call for a geothermal borehole logger for Expedition 376, and I went and I did some background research and I saw this was in an arc setting and they're gonna be doing geothermal borehole logging, I just signed up. I couldn't pass it along. My role here on the ship is a petrophysicist. I'm very interested in how the temperature distribution in this volcano drives hydrothermal circulation processes. Hydrothermal processes at volcanic arc settings are not really well studied when you compare it with how well the mid-ocean ridges are studied, especially from a temperature point of view. Mainly I work on measuring thermal conductivity of the recovered core samples, and with respect to the downhole measurements, I'm particularly interested in the temperature measurements that we make downhole. We use these numbers as a foundational stone for building much more complex numerical models of the volcano. So these are the numbers that go as different parameters or different boundary conditions when you're doing numerical modeling. When you simulate the entire volcano based on these particular field observed conditions, it's going to give you a better result of how the volcano is working. My primary goal is to build a sort of like the mathematical and a numerical model of the thermal structure of the Brothers volcano, and in turn expand it to the entire subduction zone scale modeling of temperatures, which probably, I think, given the uniqueness of the expedition, will be very useful for other scientists who are planning to study the arc volcanoes in terms of heat flow and temperature. My favorite thing about being a scientist is surrounded by fellow scientists. Trusty TCON team, they've helped me a lot with making all the measurements, and they're amazing. I like to listen a lot, and I find that when I just sit quiet and listen to people around me talking, I learn a lot of information and I'm able to integrate information much more faster. Anyone who's interested in pursuing whatever they are dreaming of, I would just say follow your curiosity. If you're curious about something, just get up and do it and just follow it. This is my first experience being at sea for a long extended period of time. Here, all I have to do is just focus every single day on what we are here to achieve. Here on the ship, you look at a lot of technicians, you look at a lot of the drill crew, the people who are manning the ship, who are cleaning the ship, who cook for us, who keep us healthy, who keep the entire ship going on. So it's given me such a broader perspective that to a large project like this, for some kind of cutting edge science to happen, it's not just the scientists, we just form a very small part. It's a bigger team than that who keeps us going.